we are moving to our haul out point.
I managed to unlock it just in time, baby.
They're still moving those things.
It looked way worse in the water than
what it did look way worse in the water than it does.
It's actually not even that bad.
We bought an old abandoned catamaran, spent 2 years rebuilding her, and embarked on a 7,000 mile journey across the Atlantic Ocean to our dream cruising grounds, the beautiful Caribbean.
Subscribe below and follow the adventure as we explore our way up the Caribbean chain of islands to the beautiful Bahamas.
It was time to haul out Lady Africa for some maintenance after our 7,000 nautical mile journey across the Atlantic Ocean. We opted to get hauled out here in Clark's Court Boatyard as the reviews were pretty good.
We are moving to our haul out point. We're going to go to Clark's Court Marina. Yeah, 10 o'clock is our haul out time and I think it's like 22:10 at the moment. We just got about 5 minutes of motoring to get there.
In all other circumstances, you probably wouldn't have to haul out since we've only been in the water for a year and a half. But because we did the Atlantic crossing, I mean, we put 7,000 miles on her in one go. So she needs a little bit of TLC, and upkeep is better than repairs. Maintain your stuff and you don't have to sit and repair most of the time. So that's what we're gonna do, get all jobs done so that she's good for another 2 seasons hopefully, and then we can play and not work as often fixing
tied up, and now we're gonna head over to the office, do our last little bit of paperwork. You can see we're in the slip literally. There's a crane, and we take our dinghy because it's gonna stay in the water. Hop in now. Hold that if it wasn't for this plane.
I know. We would have stayed in. And we wouldn't have so much added work because you're bored in Grenada.
Take it in. Lady A getting hauled out in Grenada.
She's so small. Did you hear what he said? He's like, oh, your boat's so cute.
Cute's another word for small. Nobody ever wants to hear that.
I do. I think she's cute.
That pipsqueak.
Before we could get hauled out, we needed to make sure all necessary paperwork had been completed.
This is the size of the Transnet one, not? No, it's the size of the Transnet one. We'll have to put it on comparison photo. So we did all the paperwork and then now we're gonna get hauled out. So it was pretty quick procedure and we got their stuff together here, which is pretty nice. So we're looking forward to boat work, but it comes with the life, I guess.
I managed to unlock it just in time, baby.
No, they're not lifting it. They're still setting the strap.
Getting hauled out is always a pretty stressful situation for us, as the boat is our whole life. One wrong move and it's going to cost us a lot of money. But the boatyard guys knew what they were doing, which made the process a bit easier on our hearts. Don't need to know about that. I'll protect you with my lies. You don't need to know about that. Don't need to know about that. Just let me love you. Just let me love you. Just let me love you. Just let me love you, 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 just let me love you. We were too small to be pulled by the tractor, so the crane had to move us slowly and steadily to our new spot. We only realized how much bird poop was on our solar panel when we saw the drone footage. Don't forget to subscribe below if you haven't already and click on the notification bell to alert you when we upload a new episode, and like this video as well as share it with your friends and family. It's a free way you can support our channel. You see that orange Nexus catamaran called Alani? Yeah, that's my next Christmas present from Ricky. A girl can dream, right? There were some insanely nice boats in this boatyard, and obviously we couldn't help but check it out while Lady Africa's getting hauled out. Alejo, Andrea, Ozzy and Echo, also known as Living Acuna, were also in the boatyard doing some boat work, and they came over to say hey.
Yeah. Usually when they sling it over here. Yeah. Because she's not, no cork, solid fiberglass. This thing will sail.
Oh, geez.
That thing will be like a bullet in water. That's the thinnest holes I've ever seen. And this thing's like 70 feet long. Check how narrow that is. Hey?
How insane is that?
Wow. That's like a Hobie cat, a 60 foot
Hobie cat, yeah.
Yeah. It looked way worse in the water than
what it did look way worse in the water than it does.
It's actually not even that bad.
But yeah, this is the reason why we're hauling out to do these.
Yeah.
Okay. Otherwise we would have only hauled out in like next season.
Oh.
But that, so now we're out, we...
But that's not bad.
We'll do some touch-ups on the anti-fouling and clean-up and everything.
We're good for
But we
two.
Said 2 weeks to be safe because we don't know how... Okay. But we're going to try and be quick.
Okay.
We can get back in the water. So we want to put crop speed is on the just the blade. Like that's anti-fouling on there and that's 2 years and it's still on there. So I'm not going to worry about putting crop speed on there. So I'm just going to put it on the blades. The sail drive is just anti-fouling on there. Just going to put some more layers on there. And it's perfect. It's you can actually see. But we did put like 7 or 8
layers.
Yeah,
we did.
So I was wondering what the guy's doing. He's like he's holding a bottle of water up. He's actually seeing that the boat lies perfect for all the water to flow off the boat and it doesn't stay, even though we're not going to be on storage. Like, they know what they're doing. They've been doing it long. They're good.
Good service.
Well, from what we saw, like Clark's Court was the only place that we could, well, this cock caught in Grenada. It's the only place where we could live on the boat while doing it and for more than 5 days. So if you're less than 5 days, I think the other yards might allow you. But like more than 5 days, you can stay on the boat and the service just been good. And their price was the best, so.
Yeah. And we're pretty like we're in a good area too, like close to everything.
This is central, you can get everything done here. So I think this is made sense for us. Drop the rudders and check that everything looks good. We could.
I get more work, maybe. Just I see you getting excited for work now, huh?
It's a little hot, but
it's so hot.
It's very hot.
Babes, I gotta go edit today. It's Tuesday. I really do that.
I'm just gonna grab the pressure washer today. Now maybe I'll let it dry. It'll get weak, and then hit the pressure washer.
So we go get ice cream while we wait for it to dry.
It's so hot. You know what I think? Tonight's actually going to be a good time to work.
I think it was...
Cool down, open up the head. What is on your neck?
It's called a freaking ant. Those ants that bit my feet, bit my neck. It was from the lemons.
Jeez, that looks like you touched that poisonous tree.
No, it's an ant. He bit me and it burned so bad and I was like this the whole day.
Here's one of the other things we hauled out for. These little marks. They looked so bad underwater. And now that it's out of the water, it's actually really nothing. It's a little bit of anti-fouling touch up on it. This is from Ascension, like those scratches. They had this big ass freaking mooring balls.
No, from St. Helena.
Oh yeah, St. Helena. Yeah, that was St. Helena's mooring ball playing bumper cars with us. See, it hit us here a few times too. Yeah, that is bad prep. Good identification. Looking good.
The 2K inside, sand it down and then make it higher.
Where?
For the anti-fouling inside.
Oh yeah. Give it a light sand and then just put primer, epoxy primer.
2 coats of epoxy primer.
Yep, and then raise it up. Done.
That's what we did before.
Yeah, because what you can see here, like if you have a look at the line here, check out drops off on that side, and I don't know how to notice that before. And yeah, it's catching. So the water line's still a little bit low, but like because of the water lapping, it kind of gets a little higher.
And the metal piece?
See? That's you can see there on the inside how dirty it is, just on that lower piece there. So that's pretty much all I want to get rid of.
So you're only going to do that one piece?
Yeah, pretty much. Make it level. Don't have to come up to here. Because this line's already high, yeah? Check. like the water line's really only over there and it laps up to over there, but it's really only a there. Back in the lines, the belts done.
Ricky's gonna go on a cleaning spree now. He's gonna chuck away so much stuff because we are heavy.
We out and the hulls are dry. We're just waiting for the water and there's water right there. I just found a tap. I wonder if we could use this tap here. Well, that's water there. And suppose I could just plug into one of those. Probably just have to wait for the yard guys just to tell me I can do it. I think I threw our extension lead away, our shoreline away, because I'm like, well, we're never gonna plug in. Maybe our friends on Akuna might have one, Aleo might have one. I'll probably go ask him. So just need a lead from there to there, and then a hose, plug in there. I can power wash it quickly, get that done, and then start onto what I really want to do, which is, this boot is, we took it off on the passage. If you haven't checked that video, check it out. And then that one, I just pulled it off now. And we're going to put prop speed on these, so we're going to sand them down nicely. Get it so that all the barnacles are gone. Put prop speed on that, change our anodes to split anodes, and I don't think we need to service the gearboxes. I think the gearboxes were serviced recently, but maybe I'll do an oil change. I'll just check what hours, but I really don't believe this thing's done much hours. I'll check on the logs. I think that gearbox got 50 hours on it, that's it. So the engine's got about 330 hours. I did these gearboxes I think in Ascension, and we haven't motored much since then, so that should be good. We know that this one's slightly milky, and I think it was when I initially installed it, front seal. I'm going to change the anodes anyways, and on this anode you actually remove the main bolt that comes out. So I'll probably pop that one, put new seals just as a safety measure, and then we know it's good. Take the props off, put prop speed on it. And then around the boat, there's just some touch-ups here and there. We're going to add some more anti-fouling. But the anti-fouling looks good, man. You can still see this. There's the brush marks from when we painted. So now don't look at those marks. That's from me cleaning it. But still all the little stubble from the roller. See? So if you got the boot on, you get like literally... Okay, that's where the boot was starting to open up. But over there, like you get no growth at all. And on the other side, if you don't have a boot, check at this. Like, I don't know if you can see in there. Let me see, it's full of growth in there. And that's what happens. And here we've got anti-fouling. We'll put definitely another 4 or 5 coats of anti-fouling on these legs and take it right up to here. So that'll be really well covered and be good for a really long time. As our monster mantis, which keeps us sleeping like babies at night. We're gonna change the anchor. Oh, well, not the anchor, the chain. So chain we gotta change because at the moment we only have 30 meters of chain or 99 feet, which kind of
doesn't allow us to get 5-to-1 everywhere. Obviously in some places with the anchorages, when they're super full, you're not going to put a 5-to-1. But if you're in 50 meters of water, we pump everything out and we never nowhere near 5-to-1. So we've got to do that. We've got to increase. We at least want to have like 50 meters of chain. That would be good. We've got 100 meters of road behind it, if I remember correctly, like 100 meters, which is more than we'll ever need. But stuff super light, doesn't take up much space, so that's fine to have. But we need 50 meters of chain. That's what we're wanting to have. Even though when we get to the Bahamas, we'll probably never use most of the chain, but be on the safe side, we're good. But anchor feedback has been amazing. So since we got the anchor, no problemo.
Here he comes, babes. That dog hates the freaking drone.
Don't forget to subscribe below if you haven't already and give this video a big thumbs up. See you guys next week.